the world's first celebrity transgender, Mal Frith, was buried in St. Bride's Church on Fleet Street, and has a John Milton wrote the poem on top of his tomb, and it speaks about whether he be a he or a she in the next life. And I think that, I mean, the 1600s was really dominated by conversations about gender mobility, and it's eventually led to the Civil War. It was not certainly about democracy, as the pro-democracy body who fought with the Puritans in the First Civil War found out in 1644. They realised that it was about the abolition of democracy and the desire for a religious military dictatorship. And John Lilburn, who wrote the Bill of Rights for America and was imprisoned in the Tower, he converted to, he became a Quaker, who were persecuted like Catholics by Cromwell. And they'd have liked to have hung, drawn and quartered him like his supporters, but he was too popular for that. So, and again, the Mal Frith, the world's first celebrity transgender, was in his 50s when the war started. He became a highwayman just once, just a one-off, that he rode out and he shot General Fairfax, just missed his heart, shot him in the shoulder, and was sentenced to be hung, drawn and quartered. He managed to get 4,000 quid, which he gave to the King's cause, King Charles I's cause. And but rather than being hung, drawn and quartered, he disappeared from the radar, and in 1644, he pops up again in Bedlam. So he was hidden in Bedlam for 2 years and then released in 1644, declared sane. Lived out the rest of the war, unfortunately didn't make it to 1660, when Charles would have, well, I'm sure he would have at least knighted him and given him a wonderful send-off, but he died just before, in the months leading up to it. But there was still much celebration going on, and he was counted a hero in the last years of his life, which is sweet to think.